In this video, the new ant farm for my Camponotus Nicobarensis and the colony after 15 months under my care, right after the intro. Hello, I wholeheartedly welcome you all to our first AntsVienna episode of the year. It took me admittedly long enough, but I also visited my family during the holidays, and January is generally the month where I plan the whole year through. With that being said, I want to wish everyone a happy, healthy, and successful 2020, which is probably going to be a truly eventful year, given the circumstance that our colonies keep growing and many of them will probably be exploding this year, needing new setups. So we're going to have regular colony updates and even more build videos to make. So before I go into our promised talk about Camponotus Nicobarensis, I want to kindly ask you to like and subscribe if you haven't already. Now, let us jump into the story of our Camponotus Nicobarensis colony, which is actually a pretty long one, to be honest. Everything started way back when I bought them in November 2018. Not only were they the first colony that I bought, because every other ant colony I've actually found queens myself and grew them up to the point where they are now, but Camponotus Nicobarensis were also my first exotic ant species to keep. So I had to solely rely on the information I could find on the net about their keeping. And that was obviously far from enough. The footage you see now is taken a couple of days ago, but let us jump way back to the first setup that I made for them. That was the red AntsVienna cube, along with that rectangular outworld with the wood stick in it. The problem I faced keeping them in this setup was that neither did I know what temperature they actually are in, and the control I had over it was actually really poor, since the heating mat I was using was designed for plants, meaning gardening, and not for keeping pets. As a result, the ants didn't seem to like it, and always switched places in the ant cube itself, being unable to find the right spot temperature and humidity wise to lay their eggs. Being unable to lay eggs for a while, the first nanetics actually starting dying out, and this started to concern me. So, as I was researching keeping tips online, I came across that acrylic formicarium, which seemed pretty solid at first glance. So I decided to order it. Meanwhile, until it got shipped, a few weeks had passed, and many war workers had died out. So I decided not only to prepare the new setup for them, but also upload that 4-month update video where I basically asked everyone watching for tips on keeping Camponotus Nicobarensis, because I really wanted to save my colony. And at this point, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, because I received many answers with many useful tips on that video. And I think the antkeeper community is awesome, because when it comes down to it, there's actually always more than one person willing to help you. Now, I could be talking on and on about it, but to sum it up, if you want to know exactly what answers I got, I will link the video right now in a card for you, so you can check the comments out and pick any of them that might be useful for you too. Meanwhile, I had connected the test tube to the new acrylic ant farm but the ants wouldn't move in. So I decided to let that be and took an even more drastic measure that brings us to their third setup, which is the one you are currently seeing in the footage. I took the Empire of Ants Outworld that I had bought online at Antkeeping Depot from Australia, that is also in my unboxing video if you are interested, put some aquarium gravel in it, and finally placed the test tube holding the colony in there. Following the tips I had gotten from all of you, I bought and started using a new heating mat designed for pets. It has a power of 7 watts and you can regulate it. I put it underneath half of their setup so that the ants can freely choose where they want to be, and established a temperature range from 24.9 degrees up to 31 degrees Celsius in said outworld. And guess what? The ants really liked it. They started laying their first eggs in bunches, up to the point where I had to lay a second test tube in there so that they can expand in this one too. And while the ants were making progress on their own, I was also working on this angular nest. Speaking of which, after I finished it, I made a post on Instagram about it, and I gotta tell you guys, I really felt flattered about how many people have asked me to make them one like it. If I'm not mistaken, there were around 17 requests, and although I would be delighted to make one for each one of you asking, my 9-to-5 job doesn't allow me to put that much time into that ant-keeping hobby of mine. With the channel growing, that would be another whole story though. Anyway, to keep things short, after checking our subscriber count, which has now surpassed 500 here on YouTube, I have decided to make one more and give it away to you guys, as a thanks. So, while you're watching this video right now, I'm actually working on finishing that nest. And what I also noticed is that we have now also surpassed 1,000 followers on Instagram, which is also an eligible amount for a giveaway, so you're welcome to join us there and take part in it. Going back to our Nicobarensis colony, you should already have seen some footage of the nest being connected to the outworld and the ants being productive in it, sorting all that eggs, larvae and pupae that the queens are producing. The colony now consumes round about a whole mealworm a day, and sometimes I happen to find those big annoying flies in my house that keep me from sleep due to the noise that they make when they fly, and when I actually manage to catch one of them, my Camponotus Nicobarensis colony more than appreciate an extra snack in between. Also, in regards to hydration, I try to alternate between the two sides of the nest so that the ants have a gradient humidity level they can choose from. Plus, this side altering also ensures that the nest doesn't get too humid and therefore keeps mold in check. Now, in order to reach a short conclusion for you guys watching, my Camponotus Nicobarensis colony are finally doing fine in their new ant farm. Keeping this up would certainly result in a colony explosion to come. So I am also working on another formicarium as we speak. One that I have actually already spoiled on Instagram for the ones of you following me there. Okay guys, I hope I have covered everything that I wanted to say, since this is my very first video without a script. If you have any more tips or questions on Camponotus Nicobarensis or formicarium building, you're free to let me know down in the comments. And last, but not least, I want to leave you with a question of the day. How many of you keep or have kept Camponotus Nicobarensis? Plus, did they give you the same trouble that they gave me? I am already curious about your answers. I'll read them all, I promise. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and, as always, I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys!